made you some content. Daddy made you your favorite open wide. Here comes the content. It's a beautiful day to stay inside.
Greetings, Mood Killers. It's Eddie here, Mood Killers. And of course, always joined by a man who has the charm of a clown at a black tie event. I don't know what that means.
Oh, man.
Doesn't AI sound good. That one's a little, that's a little mean.
Oh, that's AI? Geez. Yeah, blame it on AI, sure.
AI wrote that one, yeah.
Hide behind the wall of AI. Yeah.
Bolognese Francine Marconi, here we are. The enjoyers of doom and destruction, the diplomats of dysfunction. That's what we are. Here at Mood Killers. You know, Marconi, if anyone out there needs help finding a good butt doctor, or maybe they've recently found themselves the subject of a federal investigation, yeah, we're going to help you out today with Ask Mood Killers.
I see. Yeah. A butt doctor. Yeah. Like, what's going on?
A butt doctor or a federal investigation. We got you covered. We'll answer any question you have for us. So get in those questions now before it's too late. Moodkillers@stayanal.com. Your advice awaits.
And Eddie, why are so many movies and TV shows garbage now? I mean, it's not good. Have you ever seen like these things, like a trailer, 2 seconds of it? You know, I'm not going to watch that, or a thumbnail on a streaming service. And you're like, there's no way I'm watching that just based on the thumbnail alone. Well, I have a new segment called I'm Not Watching That. And I'll tell you a lot of things that you shouldn't even bother with.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, we need Chuck Lorre to return to television and provide more content.
That's right. Yeah.
And what's the worst place to propose if you're looking to pop the question?
I'm going to say men's restroom. Yeah. No, wait, what?
You might be close to what I wanted to talk about. And what state commits the most social media sins?
Oh, wow.
Ooh, social media sins. We can talk about those. And then what state commits the most? We have a lot to get to on Mood Killers, the only show where hope goes to die. Mood Killers. Look at that. We're on that new Threads thing the kids are all talking about, Marconi. we want everyone to come and join Mood Killers on Threads. And
is it still fun? Are you done with it already?
I'm having fun. My problem with it is I'm starting to see it become more and more promote-y with people. And brands, you know?
Yeah.
When it first started, everybody was having fun, talking about how great the platform is, and just kind of goofing around. It's kind of just, it's starting to lean into the downfall of social media already. What do you think?
I think that basically social media for fun is kind of over. And this is a last ditch. People want it, but then what happens is they see dollar signs because, you know, they have over 100 million people on there. So, and it's only growing every second. I mean, the last I checked, it was 100 million. I'm sure it's more now, but it's like one of those things where, you know, it's money. So it's algorithms and you can't see all my content. And why do they keep on every social media platform, no matter what you do, they're always pushing that you suggested followers for you, follow this celebrity and that one. It's always celebrity. Why do they get that for free? Like, who's...
I don't know. Yeah, like, why do the celebrity... It's like if you have that check mark next to you and you're in Fresh Prince of Bel-Air in the 90s, suddenly I have to follow you?
Well, Alfonso Ribeiro,
how about Marconi?
Yeah,
sure, but I think Marconi and me, Mood Killers, our account, I think we deserve to kind of pop up occasionally, just Alfonso.
That's the thing I would say is the celebrities don't need it. They've already got, you know, hundreds of thousands to millions of followers. Why not the ones with the less? Hey, these guys are kind of, you know what it is? It's just laziness because they're just going with, oh, these are a bunch of popular accounts. Go follow them because they're, you don't know, you'd already know them. And nobody is sitting there going, well, this account is actually pretty good. You should maybe follow this one, you know? And I think that's what it is. There's nobody selecting them. It's just some algorithm thing. But, and then at the same time.
But it's not fair though, because, you know, it's suggesting all these celebrities and celebrities already have happiness because they're famous, and we don't have happiness
You're
yet.
Saying you'd like us to be famous without having
so
to work
out. So,
yeah, right. We'd be so happy.
Yeah. That's how you find happiness, right?
Right.
By followers.
Right.
Trying. But yeah, anyways, follow us on Threads. We are Mood Killers on Threads.
Ask Mood Killers.
Maybe we can answer a quick question here. Mood Killers, is it considered proper etiquette to wear a clown nose during a job interview? Okay, I think that's a troll question. It's got to be a troll question, right?
Yeah.
Clown nose during a job interview.
Nobody's doing that or thinking about that. Nobody's confused. That's obviously duh. No. Unless you're going to a circus interview. Even then, I don't believe clowns go to an interview for being a clown
with a clown nose?
Yeah, that's part of, you dress up when you're performing, not like, it's unprofessional to go into the office that way, you know?
Would it ever be appropriate to wear a clown nose during a job interview, I wonder? I'm trying to think of a situation.
Unless it was like an audition for playing a clown, I guess. You know, sure. That might be the only way. But
yeah, I guess what's the job? What are you trying to be a clown or what is it? Yeah, I don't know.
I think
we helped.
Not really, but it's okay. It's fine.
Yeah, right. It's fine.
Ask Mood Killers.
Okay, we're answering your questions. Ask Mood Killers continues. You can send us your questions. We're on Threads, so follow
like
Mood Killers.
Just plug that away as hard as you can.
Threads. Threads. Damn it.
Don't you love when you're on a social media thing and you're kind of excited because it's new? And it's been because we loved Twitter when it was fun. And then Elon Musk, I mean, it hasn't been fun for years. It's not all Elon's fault, but he didn't help it any. And then you're just like, okay, great. I'm free from that. And now what? I want to post some silly thoughts somewhere. And now I got Threads.
Right.
But then you've got people that are like, yeah, I don't really. What's that? Why should I sign up for? Well, don't. Because
it's fine.
Yeah, we don't care if you're not going to do it. But if you are there, we're there.
It's just like, yeah, unfortunately, social media is a thing and we're there. Okay.
Yeah.
That's all we're saying. It's
right.
Like if social media weren't a thing, we wouldn't be there. But
right.
It is. So it's not our fault.
Exactly.
Mood Killers. Is it possible to be on a seafood diet without actually liking seafood?
No. Because you got to, if any kind of, and when you say diet, you have to be careful because, of course, diet
right.
means, you know, fad diets and, you know, that kind of stuff. But diet actually does mean what you eat, but it's just improperly used. But what I would say is you have to be able to like what you're eating. So find foods that are healthy for you that you like. You know, some people like chicken and they can find a seasoning that's good and it's not too filled with sodium and it's kind of, you know, a little healthier. Or if you make, I like protein bowls, things like that. But if you don't like seafood at all, no, you're not going to stick with that. It's not good. The thing is,
no.
You got to find things you can live with for, you know, for a long time. Because that's how you do it over time.
And honestly, these people who say that they don't like seafood, grow up.
Oh.
I mean, come on.
I'm not a
you
big
don't like
seafood,
seafood
guy. I don't like...
You're not?
I
can't eat cocktail shrimp?
Shrimp is about as far as I go. I don't really...
there you go. You like sushi?
I mean, I do like sushi. But I'm not like a big... I can't think of anything like, you know, like exotic fish or anything like that.
I don't like the crazy sushi. I'm not going to do an octopus or anything like
no.
that.
No.
You know, I like the tuna roll. That's fine. Except I like tuna fish sandwiches.
Yeah, that's right.
A little bit. Put a little avocado and cucumber inside of there.
The Philadelphia
that's seafood
roll,
to me.
The California
that's
roll, you know, the
right.
the big that's seafood ones.
Yeah.
No, I do like crab rangoon. Is that anything?
There you go. Yeah. Mood Killers. How can I become an expert in avoiding conversations about the weather? I don't like small talk.
Oh, is this one for you?
No, but I mean, if you can answer this for me, I'll probably.
I feel
take
like
your
people are too.
It.
You know, I think people just when they say that, it's. It's another thing to be irritated about. Sometimes people say it. Sometimes people mean it. But for the most part, now that's almost irritating. The more people have to tell you how much they don't like small talk.
Right. They don't like, yeah. I get that. But you know, when I was in an Uber the other day and then the guy started to talk about the weather, and I will say I do go on autopilot, and yeah. I noticed half of my brain daydreaming while sure. I was speaking.
Yeah.
So, and then I caught myself in that. I'm like, why am I exerting any energy on this? This is like not a fruitful conversation. Right. I'm gonna close the door, get out of this Uber, never see this person again. And oh yeah, we talked that it's about how it's 65 degrees today, and I wasted my precious voice talking to this guy. I need these pipes for mood killers.
Well, that's right. I mean, yeah, vocal fatigue right. is a thing. You should just you should tell him I got to rest my voice. Sotto voce.
I'm a big radio star.
Yes. Don't you understand? And you just like start doing the throat mist in the back of the car. Like,
yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Haven't you heard of me? I'm Ryan Seacrest.
Eddie, it's a new segment I call I'm Not Watching This. I'm Not Watching That. Uh-huh. Whatever. And there's so many movies that have come out and are about to come out that I'm like, no thanks. I've got movies, I've got TV shows on streaming services. Some of them I just don't even want to give a chance to because I know I'll be disappointed. And, I'd rather rewatch movies I like. So, and I think a lot of people, there's got to be more people than me that feel this way. There's a new Wonka coming out, the Willard Wonka movie.
Yeah, I was about to watch that trailer before we got on the air today and I ran out of time. So am I not missing anything?
I didn't even watch the trailer.
It has who does it have in it? It has that kid,
Timothy Chalamet, the Dune guy.
Yeah,
or whatever.
That kid.
And
Dune. Yeah, he played Dune, right?
And there's nothing against him, but I don't want another Wonka movie. I guess the last one.
The Wonka.
Yeah, yeah. And then I guess this is like a prequel. Really, we have to do a prequel of Wonka now.
Is anybody that interested in Willy Wonka? Why does Hollywood think that people love this character? He's a candy guy. He had a factory, chocolates. We get it. Yeah, get over it.
And somebody like said, like, hey, take the creepiness of Willy Wonka. That's the great part of him. He's a creep. I think it's hilarious that he's creepy. And now they're going to make
killed children in the original. I mean, that's what we want.
Didn't kill children. But I think like, Johnny Depp did an okay job, but I mean, the original is the best one. And I don't know. It's just, we don't need, do we need to like Willy Wonka? I don't understand.
Why?
Yeah.
Yeah. Why does Hollywood think that Americans like Willy Wonka as much as they like Iron Man? Like, why?
And the other thing.
The
other movie, I don't understand. And it's so much press and publicity and celebrities, like musicians even. I was kind of disappointed in the fact that like so many like legitimate artists are excited to be part of the Barbie soundtrack and the Barbie movie.
So I heard that this Barbie movie, it supposedly has a really good script and a really good director.
Okay.
But I don't know. I don't know if I buy it.
No thanks.
Right.
Pass for me. It may be great. Who knows? I doubt it.
I bet you anything it's going to win like Best Picture or something.
Oh, sure.
And everyone's going to be like, what? Barbie?
Yeah. But, you know, the movie is so over-marketed that, I mean, I can't imagine it being great. When they do that, it's usually like garbage, you know? So, I don't know. And then I saw that there's a new Insidious movie, The Red Door. I didn't know that was still going on. That movie, they haven't been scary. They were barely scary the first time. It's with that weird doll, right? That's where Insidious comes from. There's like that weird.
I don't know. I lost track of that. I can't believe they're still making those.
I know. It seems like the original Wonka movie was their first one. They keep making them every single year. And I have nothing against, you know, people doing that. I don't need it. I don't think it's that scary. Like that nun was scary in like the second one or the first one. I don't know. Then I can't even remember which one was which. And I guess there was one particular Insidious where Joey King was involved in the movie. And she got some weird rare blood disease while the movie was filming. And they were going to have to do a blood transfusion and everything. And as soon as they were done filming and they were gone, the whole thing went away. She was fine.
Demons. Yeah, it was demons.
So that's creepy. I kind of like that, but the movie itself isn't that scary.
So. Yeah, I want to watch a movie on that situation, not the actual movie.
Right.
Make that, Hollywood.
yeah, take that. We want real blood transfusion info, please. Thank you.
I want blood transfusion the movie.
Eddie, I'm giving you a segment called I'm Not Watching That, and we talked about movies.
I have a question for you.
Yeah.
Go ahead. You can set up your site. So these are movies that you will not watch.
Well, I have a bunch of movies, but we did a bunch of movies, and I have more, but I also have a bunch of shows on streaming services that I'm not watching.
I was wondering before you get into the shows, though, because I know you want to. What do you think of the new Mission Impossible movie?
No,
will
thanks.
You see that? I agree.
Tom Cruise can go to hell. And I don't care about him.
And you know why I won't see it?
Why?
I'll tell you why I won't see it. Is because I watched the trailer and it had one of the biggest cliches ever in an action movie. And it's Tom Cruise and a bad guy fighting on top of a moving train. And I'm like, come on. This is Mission Impossible 12 and you're still doing that?
Right.
No thanks.
Yeah. No thank you. You're right. I don't need to see any of those movies. And. Yeah. There's a ton of other movies that I don't want to see, like Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3. Like the first one was good, and I don't know what they did with the second one. I don't know who's on the movies anymore.
That was a whoops.
Yeah, and sequels are, you know what, and Guardians of the Galaxy I think it was pretty good, but you know, still, whatever.
Right.
Okay, here are some of the streaming service ones I don't think I'm going to watch. I just am not in the mood. I think the cake, is it cake thing, is kind of passe now. Like it was a big deal on TikTok for a long time, so they made a show. And now they're doing Is It Cake 2? No, thanks. No, thank you.
Is that hosted by Mikey Day, that one on Netflix? Yeah.
And he's extra creepy on that show. I don't know why, but it feels creepy. I looked at him.
I like that Mikey Day guy, but he's one of those SNL guys that they can never find anything to do with. Even though, like, I think he's talented and he's kind of interesting, but he played
Eric Trump. He was good at Eric Trump. Yeah,
right. He's no Will Ferrell in blockbuster movies. He's cutting cake.
Right or not?
Right.
Okay, yeah. And then there's another show everyone like went nuts about, and all I hear is that it's god awful. Is The Idol with the Weeknd?
Oh yeah,
and Jonica Depp. You know Johnny Depp's daughter, Jonica. I don't know her name. Johnny Depp Jr.
Lily Rose.
There you go. Okay, and I'm sure you know she's attractive and everything. And I guess part of the draw to it is she's naked in half of it. But there's a lot going on in that show. I think the script is bad. I don't know, but I don't want to see that.
And so that's Lily Rose, that's Johnny Depp's daughter, of course, right?
Yeah. Jonica Jr.
Jonica, I just looked her up, and in case you're wondering what she looks like, she looks like Jack Sparrow with less makeup.
Oh. Wow, there you go. Sort of like Margot Robbie, too.
Very attractive. Very attractive. I'm not knocking that.
And here's another show I don't want to watch. Just like that Sex and the City, whatever, reboot, part two.
Enough.
I mean, the show was good when it was in its heyday, but the reboots with all these people and
they made movies, too, didn't they? I thought it was
done.
Yeah,
they did a movie, and. And then I guess there's drama, and one of them won't go in, won't do a show, be part of it. And then Kristen Davis, who I think is the most attractive one on the show, she got some bad Botox done.
Lord
forbid you're in Hollywood and you're a woman that turns 50. Oh, no. And she thought the best way to go was to do some Botox. And she's beautiful, and she didn't need to do anything, you know, but when you're in that world, you think you do. And I think she overdid it. I think people are talking.
Oh,
you
know, no.
Yeah. So that has nothing to do with wanting to see this show. I just don't, I don't think it's a story that I need to continue seeing. And
it's enough. Yeah. I mean, that show was on for, geez, like a decade. It felt like a decade.
Too long.
And then they did 16 movies, and now they're back at it again.
Right.
And then, no thanks.
And then I've given up on Peacock because I got it free through my internet provider for a while. And now it's another streaming service you have to pay for. And there's a few shows on there that you can get for free, but then there's a bunch of commercials on there. But all the, like, literally everything that I would want to watch, you have to have a premium subscription for. So, like, if you wanted to watch Everybody Loves Raymond, it's like $10 a month. And King of Queens, $10 a month. You know, all the shows that they know people would go there. The Office, you got to, you know, pay that premium price. So,
really?
Yeah. And I'm like, come on. No thanks.
Enough.
Yeah, enough is right.
Marconi, I've never proposed to anybody.
Yes,
when it comes to
what?
Marriage.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, you?
What?
I'm on one knee because I fell down.
This is awkward. Oh man.
Yeah. But I know that you proposed at one point. You were married, and I never asked you how you proposed. And I'm curious, but then I also want to tell you probably the worst place to propose to someone.
I blocked it out
recently
because I remember
how did your proposal go?
I remember spending a fortune on the ring, and
right then, well, 3 months' salary is that the standard?
It wasn't
right?
Even that. I had signed a bonus with a company to do like a 7-year contract with the radio company.
Whoa!
But the thing was with the whole deal is just had started doing morning radio, and I don't know. You know, with when you're used to it, you know, by now I'm used to it. But back then it was like, you know, I was used to doing afternoon radio and, you know, staying up all night. And that was my normal schedule. But then I had to get up at 4 a.m. And I was just, and the station was exhausting.
Oh, that'll wreck you. That will wreck you.
And then I had a boss that wanted to
have radio or any job.
But then I had a boss that was like a nightmare to deal with. And he wanted us to do meetings every day until like 2 in the afternoon. So I would never get any sleep, and I had to live in we moved to Seattle, and I lived in a house with my co-hosts. It was a nightmare. So I was...
All that sounds terrible.
I was on no sleep, but I decided this was the time I was going to propose.
Because you were loopy.
Yeah, well...
How did you do it? What was the moment like?
It was something really lame. Like, we were together in a rare moment that we were in this... the temporary housing that the station paid for I live with my co-hosts, and she came up from Portland to Seattle.
It sounds like a homeless shelter.
To visit me. No, it was a beautiful, like, three-story home. And
okay. Well, I mean, knowing radio, usually they kind of skimp out, but wow, they put you up, huh?
It was, yeah, no, it was, I think they owned the place or rented it or something, but it was, it was
weird.
They used it all the time, but it was a really nice place. More of it for executives, I'm sure, not for lowly disc jockeys. But anyway, like, I don't know. I tried. I had all these ideas, and all of them were like outrageous and dumb. And I wanted to do something really special. And I just ended up doing it like, you know, in the kitchen of this place, and just getting down on one knee. And
I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. That's kind of romantic, you know. No, you think that you could have done
better?
Because
then she compared notes like. Years later, like when things weren't going well, she compared with other women, and they showed them their rings and like all this stuff. And my ring was just not good, even though my ring by far was way more expensive than any of these women's rings. And then at the same time, like, their fiancés or husbands went all out and they did all this lavish, these ideas and stuff. And I'm like, yeah, of course, I'm some schlub.
We got in a pedicab and rode in circles around Bon Jovi while he played a personal show.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah, it's like stuff like that. Oh. Jeez. But yeah, there's a lot of pressure around that wedding proposal for sure. And that's interesting. I never asked you that question before. But coming up, I will tell you one of the worst places to have a wedding proposal.
Is it in a rental house kitchen? Because that was pretty bad for me.
Well, this actually happened, and people on the internet are debating it. And that's coming up. Marconi, okay, so we were just talking about wedding proposals, and you shared your story about how you proposed in the kitchen of your corporate housing that you were staying in.
Yeah, temporary housing.
It was
nightmare.
Yeah, and not, yeah, it apparently wasn't that impressive because it was thrown in your face during the relationship as it deteriorated
it's such a
divorce.
It's such an undertaking for a guy to, like, you have to be all this creative and stuff, and I... At the time, I had just gotten, like, the career job of my lifetime, and I was completely, like, exhausted every day. Like, you know, like, when you haven't slept for a really long time or you partied way too much for, like, a couple of days, and you're finally, like, you get into bed, and your body is just like, oh.
You just, like, that, you shut down.
That's the way I felt every day. Like, I was about 2 minutes away from death. But I had to I would sleep, and then I would.
Terrible.
And I'd be, and then 2 hours later, I'd have to get up and do something, you know, like get up and do the show or whatever. And then, yeah, and then in the middle of that, I don't know why. I think it just was, it was a life move, and I was asking her to move with me to a new city. And I was like, it would be weird if I didn't ask her. And I wanted to ask her, but I,
I know. We all fall into those traps.
Yeah.
We all fall into those traps because you kind of get on the line of societal expectations and what's happening with your peer group and all of that.
Well,
and,
I just felt bad, like, having someone move with me to a different city when she, you know, moved. She went to college and then moved in with me in Portland. And then I get a job and, like, oh, you're going to move away. And, like, asking her to move to another city with me. Just felt like I needed to do the mature thing. And, like, you know,
I mean, see, that's where it all falls apart. Cause that's all BS. Like, who cares?
Yeah.
Like, it's her decision as an adult to see if she wants to go or not. And, you know, you're not in charge of anybody.
Yeah. But
you learn these things as you get older.
But, you know, like, it's, yeah, if I had to do it again, I definitely think I would have either done it differently or I don't know. I don't want to say I wouldn't have done it at all, but I can tell you, I'm not one for marriage.
Right. You tried it, though, so there's that. But a guy he's in for a marriage. We'll see how this works out for him because he proposed to his girlfriend outside of an airplane toilet. And this happened on a flight to Cancun, Mexico. This guy proposed with the help of other travelers.
Oh, no.
And as the now bride-to-be, I presume, because she said yes, she exited the lavatory, and then everybody on the plane helped with the proposal after she was done using the bathroom on the airplane.
Oh, my God.
So, yeah.
How embarrassing is that? Everyone, you're walking out. You just used the restroom, whatever you did in there, and you're coming out, and everyone's, like, attention on you. Nobody wants that, first of all. And...
Yeah,
you're going to Cancun. No,
it was like a number two, and then I do.
Yeah. Yes.
That's what happened. So I think you did a much better job. So I brought this up to make you feel better. Your proposal wasn't that bad.
Yeah, if I were him, at least wait till you get to Cancun. I mean, that seems like
I know. You're about to be on a beach, you idiot. You do it outside of the bathroom door on an airplane?
Number two, and I do. That's the greatest.
Mood Killers.